My opinion is we're at the end of about a 10 or 15 year marketing experiment that has failed for the career schools. And what we've done is we had really taken away responsibility. We had to market our own businesses and given that to third-party people in the form of lead generation. And the result of it, the consequence for our sector, is we've commoditized our businesses. We've commoditized our schools. And as a result, the result of that is that we've had a product erosion, which sucks. The good news is that the path to prosperity and the path to improving our station in our marketing starts with product. It's how we, it's the systems, the people, it's the experience we deliver, it's fulfilling the promise of creating a transformational experience for the students that attend our schools. Like, fundamentally, the question we all have to ask ourselves about our businesses is, fundamentally, do we have something worth buying? Like, should somebody, is it worth it for somebody to invest their time and their money in our enterprise, and do we deliver on the promises that we make in our marketing? Like, fundamentally, this is about product. Can we deliver on what we promise in our marketing, or is it just lip service? Is it just words that somebody wrote in a boardroom or an ad agency wrote on a whiteboard somewhere? That's the challenge we have. Product, and product extends from how you first engage prospects at that lead generation stage, and that extends all the way through the admissions process, the delivery of our programs, the job placements, externships, the career services part, through graduation and continuing education with our graduates. And when we nail it, when we hit product right, when we do it right, what happens is that an abundance of new opportunities come to us because we succeed on social media, we increase our referrals, we establish our brands as a premier place that people want to go. It's an attraction strategy. And what's awesome about it is that it comes from fundamentally doing the right thing, so your people can get behind having an exceptional organization. Marketing doesn't have to be that hard. It's basically psychology and math. It's responding to the unique wiring that we have as human beings. And I'll give you an example of that. We have a client where we're testing an advertising campaign. It's landing pages. And we've been testing three different photos. They're all very similar, that advertise the program. What we found is that one photo in particular of these three resulted in a 50% higher conversion rate. So people were 50% more likely to take action. And all that changed in the ad was this one little photo. And so the math and the lesson on that is that when we find the thing that is psychologically resonant with somebody, when we find that, and assuming that we're measuring it so that we can actually know that this is an improvement, we create a permanent result. We've permanently created an innovation that we can use for years to come. And so, fundamentally, marketing is just about testing your way to the truth. Another example would be on, most businesses have some kind of sign-up form. So there's something that is, hey, fill this form out and click a button. After a number of tests, we found that having a button that was red versus blue created a 20%, it was actually a 19.65% lift in conversion rates. So we created almost a 20% improvement. And all we changed was the color of the button. And so when you do the ROI on that, it cost, well, nothing really, or maybe $100 to get somebody to make a red button. But the return on that is permanent. That's a permanent 20% improvement in conversion rate. And the only way you find it is through testing,